That was Miles Away by the Sleepy Jackson off of their 2006 album Personality. One was a spider, one was a bird. I've never heard Sleepy Jackson before. That was decent. It was okay. Nothing I'd really start digging for immediately, but I wouldn't be mad when it comes on, you know? Kind of a country folky sound. I don't know if all their stuff sounds like that, but that's what that sounded like. We're listening to that today because we have a Beach House song from 2006 up in competition today. Hi, my name is Bean, and you're watching Battle of the Band. We're on day 32 of the Beach House tournament today. That is match 32 in round one. If you're new here and you're wondering what a Beach House tournament is, let me fill you in. We took every single song that Beach House released and we threw them into a single elimination style tournament. Now they're doing battle and head-to-head competition until one remains in the end, and that's the very best song that Beach House has released, at least so far. We're including everything from their first album on up to their latest EP, Become, released in 2022. We're going to be starting off with a song from their first album, and that is Apple Orchard, the first album being self-titled, released in 2006. And again, according to Genius.com, this one also has connotations to a failed relationship. It seems to be a theme in their songs. Its competition today is Walk in the Park, released in 2010 on Teen Dream. This album's pretty great. I can't remember this song specifically, though. And again, this is about trying to move on after you've broken up with somebody that you love. These are songs of heartbreak. Beach House is all about heartbreak. That's what they're into. Let's go ahead and get into these heart-wrenching tunes. Here's Apple Orchard.
Oh.
That was really, really good. I really enjoyed the simplicity of it. Like it was just a drum machine, like an organ synth thing, a steel guitar, and her voice, which was delightfully weird here. I really enjoyed that song. Really sets up kind of like the basis for what Beach House sounds like, really. Let's check out Walk in the Park.
Thank you.
That was really good too. A lot bigger, more epic, just as basic as far as the instruments go, but a lot more production thrown into it to make it sound bigger and deeper, more cloudy too. But I think Apple Orchard was just too charming. Walk in the Park was pretty cool, but then it goes on for a bit longer than I really wanted to listen to it, I think. Not that it wasn't a good length, it was just by the time 5.5 minutes had gone by, I was on to other things in my mind, essentially. My mind started to wander a bit. And Apple Orchard held my attention a lot better, at least today. I don't know, there was just something that I preferred about the kind of rough sound to it. It's a lot rougher. Her voice is rougher. Everything about it is way less polished. And I kind of like that noisiness to it. Like this video if you like the video, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Share with anyone you know who might be into this kind of content, and let me know down in the comments which of these two songs you would have chosen if it were you in the hot seat today. That's all the Beach House tournament action we've got going for the day, but please join me in just a little bit when we get done with some Eurythmics action for the day. Until then, I hope you all have a great night, fantastic afternoon, and a wonderful morning. Thanks for watching. Bye.